Hi friends, today I'm going to talk to you about the uncertainties of life and how to deal with them. Well, this is in context of the two sudden demise that our Hindi film industry recently seen, that of Irfan Khan and Rishi Kapoor. One wonders when such sudden losses happen in life as to how does one deal with the uncertainties of life and what is it that is actually one should be looking at and what should be ignored, and finally how to come to terms with the ultimate truth and certainty of life, which is death. Let me begin with a quote that Irfan Khan himself gave when he came to know of the cancer that had struck him. And he said, "I was going on a bullet train of success, achieving name, fame, fortune, everything that he had ever dreamed of. Then suddenly, one fine day, somebody tapped him on the shoulder. And he was surprised. It was the ticket checker. The ticket checker said, 'Well, Irfan, your destination has arrived. Please get off the train.' Irfan was surprised. 'How is that possible?' He said, 'No, my destination hasn't come yet.' Well, the ticket checker was adamant. He said, 'No, I cannot be wrong. The time is up. Please get off the train.'" Well, friend, this episode clearly shows us that anything can happen at any time to anybody. The only thing certain in life is its uncertainty. Well, once we come to terms with this fact, we feel that we are like a piece of cork swimming on a large ocean, and the ocean currents are unpredictable. They are taking you in a direction which you don't have any control over. And when we come to terms with that uncertainty of life, we should also realize that how to deal with it. Well, in such an instance, one comes to know about the strength and the design of the higher consciousness, the greater divine will, which knows better than you. And when you submit and surrender to that cosmic consciousness, that divine will, that's when magic begins to happen. That shedding of ego, that letting go, finally sets you free. And it sets you free in such a way that you feel totally fearless, and you feel a big burden has lifted off your shoulder. Because surrender here doesn't mean that you are passive. You do your best, you give your best shot, but then the ultimate reality is defined and controlled by the higher consciousness, as we say, the big plan of the cosmos. So you must all do that. This also brings us to the fact that how does one fall trapped to this pain and loss at the departure of a loved ones? Well, that is something which is always going to be happening. And this loss and devastation is felt most by those who identify themselves with this costume that we are wearing, the human body. And when we attach ourselves with only the human body and its various attachments like money, power, fame, fortune, family, mansion, etc., that's when we feel totally lost and devastated, because we identify only with the body. So then, if one comes to know about this, how does one live an ideal life? Well, friends, that you do by understanding and knowing fully well that you are not the body, you are just the soul. It is the soul which is eternal, and it is the soul which is indestructible. The body just perishes. It's just a costume that you wear throughout this lifetime. Once that realization dawns upon you, you go after nourishing your soul. And how does one nourish the soul? By helping others, by spreading happiness, peace, joy, and all the other aspects of positivity. Jaggi Vasudev has very famously said that if you live unconsciously, you die tragically. And what does he mean when he says that? He means that if you live a life where you attach yourself with the body and not the soul, and if you attach yourself only with the worldly pleasures and the material aspects, you die a tragic death. So don't fall into that trap, guys. Another thing that I wanted to talk to you about, the fact is that the only thing certain in life is death. That is something which is totally certain. The only thing unpredictable is its timing, when it's going to happen. It's a beautiful rhythm of breathing in and breathing out. But remember, one day we might be breathing out, and for some reason we don't breathe in. That's the end of the game. It's the end of the game as we know it. So this beautiful rhythm of life is just like a delicate thread of silk. A little snap, a gentle snap, it all it takes to put an end to this journey. So don't dodge death. Accept it, embrace it, because that's what the reality is. And once you do that, you're totally free and totally happy. Sorted, totally sorted. I would like to end this talk with a lovely story from the great King Alexander of Greece. When he was on his deathbed, he told his near and dear ones that when I die, I want my coffin to be carried to the burial ground by the doctors who were attending me. I want you to throw all the riches, all the diamonds and rubies that I've accumulated into on the path leading up to the burial ground. And finally, my third wish should be that I want my hands to be dangling out of the coffin when I go. They were all shocked. I said, why do you say that? So Alexander smiled and said that, I say that because I want every one of my people to realize that when my time has come, not even the best of doctors can save me. So what is lotted cannot be blotted. Secondly, I want the money and the riches to be thrown on the path because I want people to realize that all the material things that you are attaching yourself with, just stay here. You go without anything. And my empty hands would tell the people that you come empty-handed, you go empty-handed. Realize that. So friends, please come to terms with this fact that you are only the soul and not the body. And the only thing certain in life is the uncertainty of it. And once you're sorted with all this in your head, you will never be unhappy and will always be joyful, even in the face of death. Thank you.